Okay, I'm going to go deposit the other golden egg into the third nest and see what happens. I hope you all are having an awesome day if you're watching this. Today, for myself, is not an awesome day. I won't bore you all with the details. Normal life bullcrap. I think my daughter is going to be in charge of cleaning the screen when she comes over. Okay. The moment of truth. Oh, let's do this. Since she's going to be cleaning it anyway. That should be in the shape of a boogness.
Please place your offering into the bowls of enlightenment.
It's empty.
Well, not for long.
That is why I said that thing about making an offering. But hang on.
Okay.
Get on that ladder. I need to think about this cloud's wave limits.
I'm totally doing it.
Sorry.
That's a hell of a fall. Okay. Strange change of scenery. She looked a little bit disheveled. It's all right, lumberjack guy.
Hi.
Listen, I'm sorry. I didn't know you had feelings, okay?
Okay. I forgive you.
Oh, really? Great. Hey, who are you?
My name's Bella. What's yours?
I'm Curtis. Sorry, I thought you were a tree.
Have you always talked to trees, Curtis?
Hippie.
No. They only started talking recently. How can I cut down trees when they're screaming at me?
That's a band, the Screaming Trees. Nice.
Maybe you shouldn't cut down trees then.
But I'm a woodworker. If I can't cut down trees, where will I get my wood?
What are they screaming at you?
All kinds of really personal insults, like really over the line type stuff. It's been rough. But the worst part is not having any wood to build stuff with.
So you're a woodworker. Could you make me something?
Like what?
A weapon to kill Marchothra?
That dude is a bummer. But I don't think I could make something that powerful. How about a nice three-legged stool? Yeah. I haven't done a stool in so long.
Okay,
yeah, I could probably
I'd love to
use one.
If only I had some wood.
I knew that was coming.
Listen, about that big mess upstairs.
Oh, did another tree fall on my roof?
Yeah, that's it. A tree fell on your roof.
That's cool. I needed a little fresh air in here anyway. Been kind of cooped up for too long, you know?
Will you help me kill Malchathra?
Sorry, conscientious objector. But I'm not using my axe. You're welcome to it.
Ooh, think I could kill Mob Chothra with that?
Oh, well, no. I really don't think anything could kill Mob Chothra.
Oh, we'll find out.
Beware the trees.
Using this axe?
Not until those trees stop talking.
Okay, then.
Sweet. Anything else cool in here? What's this? Just art. I wonder if I can go into the room I just crashed into.
Ooh, pretty. I like how shiny the sun is.
Oh. I'm glad I went back upstairs. Damn. No. I think that was probably it for Jack Black's character at the top of that ladder before it fell.
When you hit the main trail, head east. There is an extremely territorial snake in the other direction.
Gotcha.
I like snakes, but not territorial ones.
Wait, east? West?
That ween face, the boognish face did come out, but kind of weird. Anything in the mailbox?
This guy hasn't gotten mail in a while.
Lucky. Call that the exit arrow. Maybe. Oh, this guy.
I have a feeling I might regret this.
Yeah, you might. Kind of disturbing.
Get rid of the axe, okay? Just stop screaming, please.
Ow! My troll! I'm losing sound!
Please don't scream anymore.
this whole forest!
Well, as long as the rest of them keep their mouths shut, we're good.
I'm here on behalf of Curtis, the lumberjack.
That homicidal psychopath? I once saw him hack an old lady to death.
Wow. Really?
Yes. A 300-year-old spruce, minding her own branches. Then he comes along. And the next time I see her, she's a... Oh, God, if I say it, I think I might be sick.
Say it. What did Curtis do to the old spruce?
He butchered her. Turned her into a stool. No. Oh, God. I think I just opened my mouth a little bit.
Why are you so upset?
I just can't stand by in silence while you murderous humans mutilate my brethren. It makes me sick.
Are you magic? Can you help me kill Montrothra?
Is that all you humans think about? Killing? You all make me want to puke.
You got a little something in the corner of your mouth.
Oh, that's just a little sap. I'm not ashamed. It's thick and natural, and I'm full of it.
Yeah, you are. Hey, can I have some of your sap?
You're just like the rest of them. Want to bleed us dry, steal all our thick, luscious, and incredibly useful fluids.
Yeah, we want humans pancakes.
But I won't do it, because I refuse to give you the pleasure of my sap.
I've never seen a talking tree before.
Well, I've seen plenty of axe-wielding, murderous humans. So get lost.
I'll let you get back to your screaming.
Yeah, please leave before I vomit, you foul, ruthless stump.
Whatever. I wonder if I can talk to the other screaming tree. I had a snake that looked just like that. Glad I did, though. So, seagull.
You look like a mayor.
I have to admit you're not the first person.
pleasant to tell you that, but alas, I am merely Maiden's Feast Marshal Dune, a humble man of the people, for now. And dreams, just sandcastles built too close to an angry sea. I had hopes, child, but this construction debacle under my marshalship has washed them all away.
Whoops. I don't need to enter the maiden's feast.
Hey, about your bucket hat.
What? What about it?
It looks great on you. Very fancy.
What? Fancy? But I'm a man of the people. I'm never going to win this election if I come off as posse and elite. Here, take this away from me.
Score. Didn't even have to ask.
I'm firing my stylist tomorrow.
When is Mark Chopper supposed to get here?
Any minute. So much to do.
Oh no, I threw that axe. And now, I don't know if I could have used it to kill Mog Chothra. I've got... Let's back out of this.
Yes, yes. These maidens aren't going to serve up themselves.
I wonder if I... No, I don't need that. But I wonder if I can use that for anything. Take this back to Dude.
Okay, make me a stool.
I'd love to, if only I had some wood.
Oh, duh.
Catch you later, Curtis.
Beware the trees.
Check it out, non-talking wood.
Oh, and it's so smooth. Oh, man, I feel a stool coming on.
What?
Yeah, that's a nice stool.
I feel 10 times better. Thanks for helping me get that out of my system. I want you to have it.
Really? Thanks.
No problem. I like to spread my samples around.
Well, I thought that was the deal. I thought I went and got you wood so I could have a stool anyway. I did steal a thing out of his window, though, so... And I threw his axe off into the woods. Okay. Well, I'll probably need a stool for something somewhere. I'll go talk to these ladies.
Hi, your maiden's getting ready for the maiden's feast? Hey, can I have some of that perfume?
That's not perfume. That's a proprietary luring compound known as Beast.
Some of your beast hooker?
That's better. But no, you can't. Sorry.
It's her secret sauce.
I bet it is. No, I don't want to square it now. Gross.
Nice costumes.
Thanks. Our dad made them.
They're the best fishermen in the village, so they're pretty good at tying lures.
We had to use every hook in town.
Just
why not?
Sorry. If I'm not going to give any to my best friend, Drusilla, I'm certainly not going to give any to you.
I said I don't want any. I don't use performance enhancers. Isn't somebody going to miss those hooks?
Not as much as they're going to miss us.
You're going to make them cry.
I doubt they're going to miss you at all. Okay.
A silent stranger approaches. Not so fast.
Sweet. Oh, I thought it was a gun.
Darn. All out of holy tear gas.
Use the staff.
Oh, yeah. Look. And the dead-eyed god sees no one.
Who are you two?
I am Dead-Eyed Dawn, and this is Demi Courtney.
Hi.
What is this place?
The Dead Eye Pyramid. Tomb of the Dead Eye God.
As if you didn't know.
Can I go inside?
You wish to invade our holiest of shrines? Why?
Because I'm American. That's what we do.
I don't know. It just looks cool.
It does? You wouldn't know. We're blind.
Oh, sorry.
Oh, shit.
But no one enters the Dead Eye Pyramid. No one. Well, unless.
What?
Well, if she could solve the riddle of yorn.
Oh, yeah. If she could solve that, then she'd
Could you remind me how the riddle of Yorn goes one more time?
You always take us down when we are in our prime. Devour your sweet rewards, yet I'll return in time. A child of mine will rise out of his rotten bed, up from a hidden pit long after I am
Peach.
Dead.
Whoa.
Yeah. Bring us a solution, and you may enter the pyramid.
Oh, I got you.
Bye.
Sense you later.
Check it out. Fruit.
No thanks. These are our only robes. We don't want to get them all sticky.
It's the answer to your riddle.
But it's just a fruit with a pit inside.
Oh my god.
Oh my goodness. They didn't even know their own riddle.
I didn't get that. Oh man. That's been bugging us all day.
But what does it have to do with the pyramid?
Huh? Oh, nothing. It's just something our friend Becky Yorn told us this morning. She thinks she's so smart. I can't wait to rub this thing in her face.
So, can I go in there now?
Oh, yeah, whatever. Knock yourself out.
Sweet.
I'm going in.
Okay.
Strange.
Guess this is where they buried their old god. It's that same religious symbol, but this one is recessed, like a socket. I don't think that will fit in this socket.
Hey, it was worth a try.
I wonder what that symbol means. The top of this pyramid is transparent. So strange. The top of this pyramid is transparent. So strange. The top of this pyramid is transparent. So strange. There's that symbol again. That symbol is so strange, but familiar. What is that a symbol of? A three-legged
bowl? I don't know.
Maybe these people worship donuts?
No, that would be Homer Simpson. No exit there.
This shape doesn't really make any sense to me. That will fit in the socket.
So, nothing to be had down here.